get real nourishment, we have to take our food directly from the source. And it becomes more difficult constantly. People are so well educated these days. It's all those horror films and television. Everybody knows about garlic and steaks through the heart.
Yes, we all have our cross to bear.
I'd rather you didn't use that word.
What's this?
Oh, that's a monster's genealogical chart. You see, first we have the primate monsters, vampires, werewolves, and ghouls. Now, a vampire and a werewolf would produce a werevamp. But a werewolf and a ghoul would produce a weregoo. But a vampire and a ghoul would produce a vamgoo. A weregoo and a werevamp would produce a shaddy. Now, a weregoo and a vamgoo would produce a maddy. But a werevamp and a vamgoo would produce a ratty. Now, if a shaddy were to mate with a ratty or a maddy, the results would be a muck.
A muck?
Frankly, that's just the polite name for a mongrel. You know, it's quite simple, really. All you have to do is remember the basic rules of monsterdom. Vampires sup, werewolves hunt, ghouls tear. Shaddies lick, maddies yawn, mocks blow. But shadmocks only whistle.
Shadmocks?
If a muck were to mate with any of the other hybrids, their offsprings would be called shadmocks.
And they only whistle.
Well, they don't do it very often.
Doesn't sound too terrifying.
Oh, but you should see the results of a shadmock's whistling. Shadmocks are the lowest in the monster hierarchy. Yet they have this power.
What happens when a shadmock whistles?
I heard of a man once who saw the results of a shadmock's whistling. That's all he saw. And yet...